Lewis, your line is now live.
When we spoke after your last victory against Daniel Madrid, you told me you're extremely satisfied with the win. I'll actually quote you here. I was pretty satisfied. It's a great feeling to put a guy into another dimension. You said you were happy showcasing you're not just a one-trick pony. What can we expect to see from Johnny Eblen on Friday?
I'm just going to continue the streak. I'm going to put on a good show and hope you guys enjoy it.
Kevin, your line is now live.
You've been on an 8-fight win streak, you know, solid streak at Bellator. You're in the rankings. You know, where do you see yourself right now from the title picture?
Not sure. I haven't fought a ranked guy yet. I'm number 5. Yeah. After this fight, we'll see where it goes.
All right. Listen, last card, Taylor Johnson, you know, fought and won. And he said he has some unfinished business with you. Are you going to welcome that challenge later on if it's available?
Sure. I'm always welcome to challenges.
Santiago.
Hi, Johnny. Greetings from Amsterdam, and thank you for the time. This will be your 3rd fight in a row at the Mohegan Sun Arena. How does it feel to be back again? And just overall, how are you experiencing this fight week thus far?
Everything's been good. Everything's been going smooth. I really like coming here and fighting. It's like going to work, you know. Just you ship out, beat up a guy, and you come back home, you know. So it's nice. It's nice coming back to the same arena. It's nice coming back and fighting for Bellator.
ATT is doing a phenomenal job here in Bellator. I mean, Amosov won the title a couple of weeks ago, and there are big prospects like yourself, but also Cody Law and Roman Feraldo, who are also going to fight on this card. Well, not Roman anymore, but can you maybe talk about the team spirit in the gym and what makes this gym so special according to you? And did you bring Mike Brown for in your corner?
Yeah, I did bring Mike Brown, and it's just a winning culture over there, man. It's a lot of fun. We show up, we put in the work, and then we go showcase our skills out in the cage.
Johnny, this will be your 5th fight with Bellator. You're 4-0 right now with the promotion, and you have a beautiful spot on the main card. Are you looking to make a statement on Friday and then finally fight someone who's also ranked like yourself? Because to me, your last couple of performances speak for a ranked opponent next. Would you agree?
I agree. I'm looking to show up, put on another good performance, and then hopefully we fight a top 10 guy. That'd be great.
Because you are the number 5 ranked middleweight right now, Johnny, I wanted to ask you about the big middleweight title fight next month between champion Gegard Mousasi and John Salter. How do you see this fight play out?
I'll be tuning in. I'm thinking Gerard. He's a little bit more well-rounded, I think. Yeah, it should be a good fight.
Dylan?
I'm just curious because we were doing an interview prior to your last fight there and just talking about the frequency with which you change your nicknames there, but it seems like you're kind of sticking with the Diamond Hands moniker there. Is this one that's going to have some longevity, you're thinking?
I think so. I had a quick turnaround. Usually I go back and bullshit with my friends and some new nickname comes out or whatever. And that was kind of my thing at the beginning because nothing was sticking. But this one might be the one that sticks.